Today, we spend the hour with a young man with autism who learned to interact with the world in an unusual way. His name is Owen Susskind. He was diagnosed with regressive autism at the age of 3. He stopped talking. His father said Owen vanished within himself. He did not speak for years. And then his dad, the Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist Ron Susskind, discovered a remarkable way to talk with his son involving characters from Owen's favorite Disney films. Owen had memorized the lines of dozens of Disney films. This discovery changed all of their lives, opening a new way for Owen to communicate. His story became the focus of Ron Susskind's best-selling book, Life Animated, a story of sidekicks, heroes, and autism. Owen has since gone to college and now holds 2 jobs. Last year, Owen, who's now in his 20s, even appeared in a Comedy Central special alongside the comedian Gilbert Gottfried, who did the original voice of Iago, the parrot, in the Disney film Aladdin.
Hello, Owen.
Hello, Gilbert.
Owen, you like doing scenes from Aladdin, right?
Uh-huh, I do.
You want to do one with me right now?
Yes, I would.
Which scene?
How about the lamp scene?
Okay, let me see if I remember any of this. I can't believe it! I just don't believe it! We're never gonna get a hold of that stupid lamp! Just forget it! Look at this! I'm so ticked off, I'm molting!
Patience, Iago, patience. The scene was obviously less than worthy.
The story of Owen Susskind's life has been turned into the documentary Life Animated, which just premiered here at the Sundance Film Festival. It's a huge acclaim. The film is directed by Roger Wass Williams, the first African-American director to win an Academy Award. On Tuesday, I spoke to Owen Susskind, his father Ron, and Roger Wass Williams here in Park City.
Owen, how did it feel to stand up at the Sundance Film Festival after a film about your life, and to have people giving you a standing ovation, not for 1 minute, not for 2 minutes, not for 5 minutes? How many minutes did people stand and applaud you?
A couple of great times, and I loved it.
How does it feel to have a film about your life?
Feels wonderful, actually.
Are you surprised at how good it feels?
Yeah.
Owen has been thriving in front of an audience. He's just, the audience loves Owen, and Owen loves the audience, and it's just been a joy to see.
So, Roger, can you talk about why you decided to make this film and how it all happened?
Yeah. Ron and I have known each other for about 15 years. We worked together years ago on Nightline and PBS. And when Ron was working on the book, he approached me and he said, this is going to make a great film, and I jumped on it. I made a film called Music by Prudence about a Zimbabwean girl with severe disabilities that won the Academy Award, and for me it's about championing the outsider, the other, telling the story of people that have been left behind, and Owen represents a whole vast population of people who have so much to offer us, and we're losing out by not recognizing the genius of people like Owen.
Owen, what does it mean to be autistic?
It means you have special talents and skills inside you.
What are those talents?
Oh, gosh. Being a good artist, and a piano player, and a good writer, author, and storyteller, and possibly a good golfer, and a great problem solver.
So each person is individual.
Yeah.
And what is your special talent?
Drawing animation, especially from Disney and Disney Pixar.
Let's take a step back, Ron Susskind, and talk about your life with your younger son, with Owen.
Since the time Owen was about 3, he gets whacked with autism. It's late-onset autism, same as mostly as kids were born with it. But he's chatting away at 2, and then he vanishes at 3, loses all speech.
What do you mean he vanishes?
Well, he stops speaking, and he won't look at you. All the signs that you look for and fear as to autism, it just sort of suddenly comes upon him in a few months, right around the time he's 3 years old. Cornelia and I, my wife, are just, you know, stunned. One of the things, though, we realize in this time of fear is that the thing he loves after the onset of the autism is similar to before. He loves the Disney animated movies. And over the years that follow, he speaks often in gibberish. You're not sure what he's saying. And right around the time that this clip occurs, we have a revelation that he's memorized 50 Disney animated movies as sound alone. And if you throw him a line, he throws you back the next line. That's what I discover the night that I hold up the Iago puppet, which is the scene that I think you're about to see.
Yeah.
Was that a big night for us?
Yeah.
It's the first time we talked since you were 2 years old.
I'm so happy. Love that night.
Yeah, it was a great
Let's
night.
Go to a clip from Life Animated.
So I go up to his room. I see Owen on the bed flipping through a Disney book. And I see, sort of over to my left, I see Iago, the puppet. Now, Iago is the evil sidekick to the villain Jafar from Aladdin. Now, I know Owen loves his puppet.
Jafar! Jafar! Get a grip!
I grab the puppet. I pull it up to my elbow. And I begin to crawl across the rug as quietly as I can. And Owen turns to the puppet like he's bumping into an old friend. I say to him, Owen, Owen, how does it feel to be you?
And I said, not good, because I don't have any friends.
Now I'm under the bedspread, and I just bite down hard. You know, I just say to myself, stay in character. And I said, okay, okay. Owen, when did you and I become such good friends? And he said, when I watched Aladdin, you made me laugh. And then we talk, Owen and Iago, for a minute and a half. It's the first conversation we've ever had.
So, that is the moment. Now, is it possible, Owen, that you remember when your dad was talking to you under the sheet with the puppet, Iago?
Yeah.
How did that feel?
Felt good.
I mean, we never had really talked before. It must have been strange for you to talk to Iago. You knew I was under the sheet, though, right?
Yeah.
But still, Iago,
well, I don't know.
Love it.
And then you spoke back to me in Jafar. Iago's the psychic to the villain Jafar.
You bet.
And what did Jafar say back to Iago?
I love the way your foul little mind works.
That was
Disney buddy Jonathan Freeman.
That was the next line of dialogue. And that's when we knew, oh my, we can converse in Disney dialogue. We couldn't speak at that point. If you threw him a line, he'd throw you back the next line. Of course, he'd outrun you quick because he had hundreds of hours in his head. And we started to speak in Disney dialogue as a way to communicate. We had no other way.
Now, before that, Owen had said a few things, and you thought he was really processing, but the doctor told you it was echolalia?
Yeah, that's a term of art for the idea that the kids just repeat what they hear as sound alone. They don't understand mostly what
they're
saying.
It's echoing.
Echoing, just like it says. And I said, you mean like a parrot? He's like, kind of. I said, can he be understanding what the words mean? He says, well, our sense, this is 1994, 95, we don't think he does. That went on for years before you have this moment with Iago. Of course, we gave him every therapy. We had great therapy. And he, before he says this to Iago, he's up to about a three-word sentence, I want you's, that's about all. But then there's an explosion when we see he's got this deep well of understanding, processing all the Disney movies.
Wait, that word juice?
It's just your voice.
Okay, explain this part, just your voice.
Yeah.
Why was this so important? How old were you when you said something that your parents did not quite understand?
Yeah, you were just shy of your fourth birthday, that's right.
Yeah.
And did you guys and your mom think you were asking for juice?
Yeah, but it was really trying to read the dialogue from Little Mermaid.
And what is the dialogue? So this is one where Ariel's the mermaid, and she has to make a trade to become human, and the sea witch,
Ursula
says to her, what does Ursula say?
It won't catch much, just your voice.
At that moment, we said, it's not juice he wants, he's saying just. I grabbed Owen, I said, just your voice. And he says, juicer voice, juicer voice, juicer voice. And it's the first time he's looked at me in a year. It's the first time he looked right at me. And we knew something was going on. It took 3 years, though, before we got to Yaga. And that's when things got crazy.
You have been listening to Owen Suskind, his father, Ron Suskind, the Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist. They are featured in the new documentary Life Animated, directed by Roger Ross Williams, which just premiered here at Sundance Film Festival. We'll continue with our conversation in a minute.